Today I'm going to give you 10 ways that you can earn trust with parents as a youth pastor.
20 youth pastor learnings from 20 years in student ministry.
Hey everybody, my name is Adam and today I want to talk about parents. And I want to give you the best, most practical advice that I've ever gotten when it comes to parents as a youth pastor. Here it is. Earn their trust. That's it. Now, that is not my idea. Credit to the legendary Kurt Johnston out of Saddleback Church. But it is critical that we earn parents' trust because, for the most part, parents still control the lives of their students. Now, obviously, this control loosens as they go from sixth grade on into 12th grade, but parents are still one of the most influential, controlling people in the life of a young person, and it's always a win for us to have their trust as youth pastors. That's it? All I gotta do is earn their trust? Well, that's not the only thing, but it's a very important first step. Okay, so earn their trust. Why do I gotta earn their trust? Shouldn't they just automatically trust me like I'm the pastor that the church has put in this role of the youth pastor? Sorry, they're not gonna automatically trust you. Why? Because as youth pastors, particularly if we're young, we're naturally better at doing things to earn trust with students rather than parents. Like the time when you had this mud event, and kids got totally covered in mud, but then you forgot to tell their parents that they were getting covered in mud. So then when the parents came to pick them up, and then their cars got covered in mud. Or it's a time where you got back an hour late from that youth event, or it's a time when you continually run 5 or 10 minutes late on your weekly programming, or it's a time that you broke the law with students and they thought it was really fun, but... Or it's those times when you were speeding in the church van, or the times when you packed 9 students into a car that's only meant to hold 5 people, or it's a time that you let students leave the church to go to Starbucks, but you forgot to consult the parent to make sure it was okay. And on and on and on, and yeah, all of those are things that I've done. Okay, Adam, I appreciate all your stories. Tell me, how do I earn trust with parents? All right, let's get into it. Number one, communicate. Communication is key, and it's essential if you want to build trust with parents. Communicate, communicate, communicate. I would suggest that you try to communicate in any and every way possible with your parents until you figure out 2 or 3 ways that actually work. I mean, you could use email, you could use social media, you could use texting, you could use old school snail mail, you could use websites. I mean, there's almost an endless amount of possibilities of ways to communicate in this day and age, but you've got to figure out how to effectively communicate in a way that parents will actually get the information that you want to give them, and then they can feedback and give you the information that they need to give you. I would encourage mass communication. I would also encourage consistent communication. I would also encourage random communication, like the random text that you're gonna send them when the weather is bad, or when they need to know something important that you're worried they're gonna forget about an event that's happening, or it's the random email that you're gonna send them as they're packing for the big summer camp or winter camp that you're doing. So communicate with them regularly and consistently, but also communicate with them randomly in ways that are helpful to them. Bonus tip right here. If you have any events or trips or things that you do repeatedly, or if you're just doing them once and it's a big event, make a website specifically for that event that has all of the information that a parent could need. So think of the parent that's gonna ask a million questions that wants to know every detail and put every answer to all of their questions on that website. All the when, the where, the why, the what, the cost, all the forms, all the downloads they need. You could put pictures on there. You could put videos on there. You could put frequently asked questions, and you literally put all the information that any parent could need and just leave it there. And it's there all the time. And then instead of getting a barrage of emails, eventually they'll learn, oh, on the website, everything's on the website, everything's on the website. And it'll be a win because the more information that's available to the parents, I think the more potential you have for earning their trust. So communicate, communicate, communicate. Number two way to earn trust with parents is lead with excellence. Simply do a great job at leading your youth ministry. If you do quality work, you'll earn trust, and this includes being organized. For example, if I'm a parent, I walk into your ministry space and things look organized and things look clean and things look like you're prepared and ready to go, that builds trust with me. Or if I walk in as a parent and things seem chaotic and things seem like unprepared or things seem out of place and hectic and unorganized, it makes me lose a little bit of trust that you actually know what you're doing in leading my kid. So lead your ministry with excellence across the board. This is everything from your social media, to your administrative tasks, to your leadership training, to your parents' meetings, to your preaching, all of it. Do your best to lead with excellence. That will help you earn trust with parents. Number three, here it is. Plan ahead and communicate the dates for everything you're doing as far in advance as possible. If you have a big trip coming on spring break, get that information out as soon as you have that information. And if you don't have that information very soon, then figure out a way to get it sooner. The more you can be planned ahead, the better. You don't need every detail a year in advance, but a lot of families are planning what their family is doing on spring break right after the last spring break ended. They're planning what they're doing next summer as soon as this summer ends. So the more in advance you can get dates on all the big things that you're doing, even the little things that you're doing, the better. Plus, if you do this, bonus, it will probably help increase attendance at all those things that you're doing if you give parents the heads up on when they're happening far in advance. You're welcome. Number four, be professional. In everything you're doing, be a professional. Don't be the stereotypical youth pastor who's like, "What up, dude?" to everybody. Yeah, you gotta be that in some ways. As a student pastor, as a professional student pastor, you have to have this switch almost, I would like to call it, where you're walking down the church hallway and there's a group of middle schoolers and you're like, "Hey, what up, guys, what up?" And you're fist bumping, and then all of a sudden you turn around and there's a parent in a business suit, professional looking parent. "Oh, how's it going, sir?" And you have to be able to flip that switch from relating to parents, to relating to students, to relating to your pastor, to relating to an old lady, and be yourself, but you have to act in a professional way. Don't treat the parents the same way that you treat their 13-year-old kids. Be professional. This includes the way you dress. So this kind of clothing is going to have a different impression than this. Now, this is still a suit and all, but hey, if a parent walks in and sees me in this, they're going to get a different view of me than if they walk in and see me in a business suit. You know what I mean? So anyways, I just noticed that I have a button missing on my shirt. Hopefully you guys didn't notice that. Be professional, people. Come on. So the way you dress, the way you talk, the way your office is organized, all this kind of stuff matters when it comes to earning trust with parents. So number four, be professional. Number five, be a resource to parents regarding cultural things that they may need to know of or they may need a heads up on. Also, have resources available for them on things that they might want as parents. This could be books, this could be websites, this could be videos, this could be links to articles and things, but parents need help and resourcing on things like social media and screens and all sorts of cultural things. Some of them are totally out of touch, some of them are not totally out of touch, but if you can have resources for when crisis hit, what do you do when your kid's cutting themselves? What do you do when they're struggling with anxiety or depression or thoughts of ending their own life or like serious, our teenagers are dealing with serious stuff these days. Their parents need help and we can give them a lot of help. As a youth pastor in our world today, there's millions of resources available out there. If you can just grab some of these resources and have them all ready to give parents when they want them and when they need them, boom, you will earn trust with parents if you can resource them whenever they need those kind of resources. Number six, think like a parent. Now you might be like, "Oh, that's nice, Adam. I'm not a parent, so how am I supposed to think like a parent?" If you don't know how to think like a parent because you're not a parent and if you have a hard time putting yourself in that frame of mind, here's a tip. Meet a couple parents. Get a couple parents that you can become friends with, that you can get on your team, or maybe they're already on your team. And everything you're going to do as a youth ministry, get their opinion. Run it by them. "Hey, how does this sound to you as a parent? Hey, what do you think about this as a parent? Hey, I've got this idea. From a parent's perspective, what do you think?" And get someone who's going to be honest with you, who can think like most other parents think, and get them to help you to think like a parent. Like I said, some of us naturally don't do this very well. Some of us do, and that's if you do, great. If you don't, get a few parents who can be on your team, who can then be a voice to you from the parent's perspective, but can also then be a voice back to the other parents to help leverage influence for you with the other parents. So number six is think like a parent. Number seven, build relationships with them. Now, I get it. Some of you guys are like, ugh, I don't even have time to build relationships with all the students in my ministry or all the leaders in my ministry, much less all the parents of the students. Ah! But it's important. Think about it. Generally, you trust people more who you actually have a relationship with, right? Like, I'm more likely to let somebody that I know babysit my kids than a stranger babysit my kids, right? That just makes sense. Now, sometimes, as you get to know them, if they're an idiot, then you're not going to trust them as much, obviously. So that goes back to the other ones about being organized and being prepared and being professional and all that kind of stuff. But get to know them. Now, I'm not saying you have to be best friends with every parent in your ministry, but strategy, become friends with at least a few of them and meet a bunch of them. Just like get to know their names at least, and then on from there. And this could be you as the youth pastor. This could be some of your volunteer youth leaders. Somebody in your youth ministry leadership team, if you can build relationships with the parents of the students, that is a win that's going to help you earn trust. Build relationships, get to know parents. Number eight, always honor parents and encourage students to do the same thing. This could be from stage, this could be when you're talking one-on-one with a student, this could be in emails, this could be anywhere. You want to always uplift parents and honor parents and encourage students to do the same thing. Guys, listen to me. Some of us have this mentality that parents are the enemy, and I've had many times when I hear a student and I tell this story about their parent, and I think, man, this parent is an idiot, or this parent is a jerk, or this parent is a loser, or this parent is the enemy. Parents are not the enemy. We need to partner with them, work with them, team up with them, and serve them as best as we can. And we're going to earn trust with them when we honor them and encourage students to do the same thing. Number nine, last one, always communicate the why. Communicate why you're doing what you are doing. If parents don't know why you're doing something, sometimes there's like, my kid's not going to that, that sounds stupid, okay? Or that doesn't make sense. If you communicate why you're doing what you're doing, boom, most people will be on board. They'll be in, they'll follow, they'll send their kids to it, they'll be on board. So communicate the why. What I like to do as far as communicating the why, especially if it's a big change or something new, I like to communicate the why in a different communication avenue. So if I normally communicate via text or email or whatever, I might send them a video where I can really express my heart and share my heart on why we're doing this particular event that we're doing. And when they get why, they're like, oh, okay, that makes sense. Boom, all of a sudden they're all in on doing it. Or even, here's what I love about communicating the why is even if they like don't like the idea, when they understand why we're doing it, they're usually like, okay, I don't like it, but I get it. And they'll go with it, and they'll send their kids, and it'll be all good. So everything you do, you have to continually remember to communicate the why. Whenever you have a chance to meet with parents in person at a parents meeting or something, communicate the why behind your student ministry, behind the big things that you're doing, behind your small groups, behind your trips and your events. Why? It's so huge. We have to continually communicate the why. Communicate the why. I think we all know that we need to communicate the why, but if parents know why you're doing what you're doing, they'll probably trust you more. There's my thoughts on how to earn trust with parents. This is super important stuff. If you want to earn trust with parents, do those nine things. And hey, holy cow, I almost forgot this one. Number 10, way to earn trust with parents is do what you say you will do. Now, this is a principle that's true for building trust with anybody, but especially with parents as a youth pastor, you need to do what you say you're going to do. That means if you say that your youth ministry will end at 8 o'clock, make sure it ends at 8 o'clock or 7:59. If you say that you're going to be home from a trip at noon on Sunday, make sure you're home at noon on Sunday. If you say you're going to call a parent back tomorrow morning, call them back tomorrow morning. If you say that you're going to send out all the information for the mission trip on Tuesday, send it out on Tuesday. Do what you say you will do. Doing that will help you earn trust with parents, but failing to do what you say you're going to do is a quick way to lose trust with parents. So do what you say you're going to do. There you go. 10 ways to earn trust with parents. Oh, and I got one bonus tip. This is super practical, and I've done this a few times, and it's won me huge points with parents. Here it is. Whenever you have a trip or an event, do this. I'm telling you, this is a huge win. On the very first night of the trip, figure out how to film and edit a quick, like, miniature highlight video of the first day of the trip and get it sent back to parents that night. This could be like a minute or less. Essentially what parents want to know is the purpose of this trip being accomplished. More than that, they want to know, did my kid make it there safely, and are they having fun? okay? This is huge. And especially with younger kids, middle schoolers, but it's true with high schoolers as well. Guys, some of the most viewed videos that I've ever made in my life are videos from the first night of trips we've done. Whether it's weekend retreats or camps or mission trips, do this. It's gonna earn you huge trust with parents. This is a generation where parents are used to being connected with their kids 24/7, instant communication. And especially on trips when sometimes they're not connected, they're nervous, they're freaking out, they're at home like, I hope they're having fun, I hope that. I've been on this and sent my kids to summer camp like, man, I hope they're having fun, I hope that. I'm checking social media every day for pictures and just trying to see my kid. I'm telling you, from the parents' point of view, parents will love you if you can send back video footage. Pictures are good, but videos even better, that includes as many of the students as possible who are on the trip. Parents want to see their kid in that video. So work as hard as you can to get as many kids as possible in the video. Send it back the night of, even if they get it at 1 or 2 a.m. When they wake up the next morning, if they have that video, they're going to love you. You're going to earn trust with them. So there's my bonus tip for you. 10 tips how to earn trust with parents. Guys, this is huge. I'm telling you, if you have the trust of all the parents of the students in your youth ministry, I can almost guarantee you your youth ministry is going to be more successful. So do whatever it takes to earn their trust. Ask yourself this question every time you're making a big decision for your student ministry. Ask yourself, will this help me earn trust with parents? If so, awesome. If not, maybe you need to make some tweaks and adjustments. So how do you win with parents? Earn their trust, earn their trust, earn their trust. Thanks for watching. Peace.